Hi, welcome to my desk. My name is Ashley, and this is day 9 of the 10-day work with me project. I'm so glad you're here. I hope you brought a task, something you want to sink your teeth into for the next hour, because we are going to work together in real time using the Pomodoro technique, which means we will do 2 25-minute work sections. That's where we listen to white noise and we focus, babe, on whatever it is we want to accomplish today. That's the time to do it. If you get bored, distracted, you can look up and see that I am right there with you chugging along. In the middle, we'll have a 5-minute break where you can get up and stretch, maybe refill your beverages, maybe plan a trip in 2022. Whatever you want to do, take that time for yourself. It is a break. If you want a little human interaction, I will be here, of course, chatting about a certain subject. As always, you know I love to chit and I love to chat. So you can stay with me for that if you want. And then after the break, we'll do our second 25-minute work section. And then after that, we can close our computers. We can go live our life knowing we already showed up. We already sat at the desk. We already took care of business. How does that sound? Great. So today I'm just drinking a big ice water. It's the only thing I've got going on. And I'm going to be working on my pilot. I would love to know what you're going to be working on and what beverages you have. Great. Well, let's jump into this first 25 minutes. It's going to fly by. You will be shocked. That's my promise to you. Make sure you're comfortable. Let's get seated. Ooh, everything's where you want it to be. Your work is in front of you. You got that killer mindset. You're ready. You're going to jump in. You're going to tackle this. Okay. I don't know why all the words are somewhat violent. Kill, tackle. Okay, you're going to embrace your work. How about that? We're going to change the narrative a little bit. You're going to hug your work out for the next 25 minutes. I'll count us in. Are you ready? Great. 3, 2, 1, go.
Thank you.
Ding, 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 ding. Woo, that was 25 minutes. I'm putting 5 minutes on the old clocky clock. We're going to have a break. Oh, get those shoulders back. Get that body moving and grooving, feeling good. Fun fact that I cannot wait to share with you is that I have gathered multiple articles to read to you today because I'm in an interesting headspace, okay? That's how I'm feeling like I'm in a weird headspace. So let's just see. I have 4 articles here pulled up, and we're just going to give, I realized as I was like choosing them that it really lets you know what I'm going through. So let's hear the first one. What to do when you don't have any ideas. That's number one. Number two, 7 ways to become smarter every week. Number three, 7 smart ways successful people respond to failure. And number four, how to deal with being misunderstood. So we're going to scratch off how to deal with being misunderstood because I meant it in a not in like a personal relation way. And like I meant it in through your writing or your work. And I'm sure you've all been there. Like you've told a joke and people like think it's serious or they think it's real or, you know, there's nothing more frustrating for me than my creative work being misunderstood. The point of my comedy is to be understood. So this, everything I could find that was like helpful advice was about like interpersonal relationships. That does not help us. This, I mean, it could help us in other ways, but not today. This 7 smart ways successful people respond to failure. You know what? I really liked this article and I was going to share it with you guys, but I got so frustrated because they kept calling successful people mentally strong people. And that just bothers me because I don't think, I'm not interested in identifying as mentally weak first and foremost. And I also think that if you have maybe, if your coping skills are like not the most helpful, or maybe you have some bad habits, like a lot of times that's learned, and that's not, doesn't mean you're mentally weak. So I'm not a fan of calling people mentally strong, but I am a fan of calling people successful and unsuccessful, because we can measure that, right, babe? Just kidding. That's a joke. I hope that that is understood. So I was going to read that one. And then the other one I was going to read, did I already say this to you guys? What to do when you don't have any ideas? I think what we're going to go for though, is to 7 ways to become smarter every week, because this is the positive one. And this is on entrepreneur.com. So, you know, they know what's up. So number one, if you want to become smarter every week, spend time reading every day. The mind is like a muscle. The more you use it, the stronger it will become. We all know this, but here I am reminding you that if you are out of the habit of reading, get back in it. I find that I fall in and out of it. I will go through months where I'm like consistently reading every day, and then I'll go through months where I'm like not. And the months that I am reading are usually my most stable, happy months. Okay. Number two, focus on building a deeper understanding. Becoming smarter takes more than just absorbing information. I love the idea that this article is like, read these 7 steps and you'll become smart, like apply these 7 steps and you can become smarter, as if that is something we can measure. I mean, I know IQ tests, whatever, but we all know those are full of problems. Okay. True wisdom comes from deeply understanding a subject. Yes. So this is telling us to focus on a deeper understanding. Okay. Constantly question and seek clarification. Ooh, baby, that's all I do. I should be a freaking genius. Diversify your day. One of the best ways to increase your intelligence involves flexing different areas of your brain. You aren't going to get any smarter by doing the same old every day while having a routine. And yet they tell us to read every day. Just kidding, because the text changes. Listen, I'm feeling randy. I don't know if that's how I'm coming across, but that is my mood today. Okay, so novelty is important. Number five, review learned information. Okay, we're almost at the end here of our time window. So I'm going to say six, keep track of ideas, write it in a notebook. And seven, allow yourself to change. Friend, allow yourself to change, okay? I'm going to put 25 minutes on the old stopwatch. We're doing our second work chunk today. Day nine is almost done. We're halfway there. We're more than halfway there. Are you comfortable? I am. I'm going to keep working on the same thing. Are you? Okay, here we go. I'll count us in. Three, two, one, go.
Thank you.
Ding, 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 ding. Wow. My friends, that's a wrap on day 9. We did it. I hope you feel good. I'm out of water. I need to go on a walk. That's what I'm feeling right now in my soul. And I can do it and feel great about it because I did my work. I hope you feel good. I'm so glad we worked together. I'll see you here tomorrow at 10 a.m. Okay? For day 10. Tomorrow is day 10. I'm so excited. See you then. Bye.